5 to go. Let's see. We'll hopefully get this sorted out as Dallas lead is 105-98. Meanwhile, the Cavs need some stops here as Luka Doncic steps back. Loose ball grabbed by Kleba in a crowd. That's a big play there as Washington wheels inside. Finds an open Kleba for three, and Max earned that. Kleba has given the Mavericks a 10-point lead.
Wow. Again, offensively, they are one of the best in the league. And when they beat you inside for rebounds and things like that, it just makes them that much tougher.
The Mavericks run is 10-0. That ball comes loose to Allen. That's a big bucket right there. It escaped the grasp of Irving. And Allen was the recipient. Mavericks 108, Cavaliers 100. We approach the four-minute mark.
Opportunity now has to be for the Cavs on the defensive end of the floor.
Kleba sends it back to Irving. Irving finger rolls inside. Kyrie now has 25. He and Doncic have combined for 70 of the Mavericks 110. Struce. Back it goes to Mitchell. Takes a bump from Hardaway. Struce fires a three. He knocks it down. Kleba came out with a contest, but Struce finds his third long-range bomb of the night. And oh, boy, Irving stepped on the baseline, inbounding the basketball, so it's a Maverick turnover, and believe me, the Mavericks have been really clean with the basketball tonight. That is only their fourth miscue of the evening.
And that's one of the reasons why they've been able to stay in control of the game, because of that. Oh!
The Cavaliers capitalize, and all of a sudden, that Maverick, a 10-point lead, has been trimmed all the way down to four.
It's amazing how things can change in this league.
That was the Mavericks' first turnover since the 8:36 mark of the second quarter. Irving long range. Oh, brother. Woo-hoo. Irving now has 28 points. He's knocked down five triples. Mitchell finds Struce. Struce looks to stay hot, and he does.
Find the open man.
Max Struce has five threes. Haymaker after haymaker. Mavericks by four. Irving baseline. He got squeezed out. Out comes Mitchell. He'll find Garland. Garland off to Struce. Struce with another. Oh, my word.
Shoot it. Supermax is on fire.
Unbelievable. Came in a 67-second span, and the Cavaliers are back within one. 2:20 remains. This crowd is on its feet. Doncic steps back. That's going to be short. And tracked down by Struce. He's been the man of the hour here in this fourth quarter.
You wonder about the Cavaliers' bigs? We have a 7-foot guy guarding Doncic. It makes him shoot an air ball.
Watch 2 minutes of play.
Mitchell with under two to go. Works on Washington. Garland fakes a three. Dumps back to Mitchell. He'll fire. He knocks it down as Donovan Mitchell has given the Cavaliers the lead.
Moving the basketball was a beautiful thing. Boom. Shoot that ball, Donovan.
Mitchell and the Cavaliers have offered a 15-3 run in less than 2 minutes. They offered a marvelous comeback to shock the Mavericks in Dallas 2 days after Christmas. Here's Irving. He's watched by LeVert. The Mavericks led by 10 just minutes ago. Doncic looks for an opening. He's doubled. Green missed the shot. He tried to draw a foul. Back from the Cavaliers with a 2-point lead.
It's called defense. Exactly what it is. The defense at the right time.
Garland is watched by Doncic. The Cavs have made their last five threes. Garland gets right around Doncic to the basket. That's blocked by Kleba. Washington has his head up. He'll bounce off to Irving. Irving. Got called for an offensive foul. And it was Max Struce at the point of attack. Irving can't believe it.
Doing a super job of waiting and staying with it on defense. coming in. He slides off on Irvin. Irvin hooks on. Right there. There's the foul right there.
Boy, that is a big call late. As we are now under a minute to go. The Cavs have the basketball in a 115-113 lead.
New possession opportunity here.
It's knocked away from Mitchell. Doncic back to Green. We're tied.
Turnover in the backcourt.
40 seconds to go. Garland is picked up by Irving. Mitchell is guarded by Green. Uses an Allen screen. Fires a three. And nails it. Donovan Mitchell as the Cavaliers come alive from long range. Late in this ball game, you see the Cavalier run as with 29 seconds remaining. He has played 38 long minutes. This man, Max Strus, has been a catalyst here in this final frame. Four threes in just over a minute to will the Cavaliers back into this game.
He brought the team back to life with his play. Those four threes have changed the whole feeling of the Cavs, especially on the defensive end of the floor.
The Cavaliers have two timeouts remaining. The Mavericks have one. Irving works on LeVert, gets inside, floats it up and floats it in. That cuts the Cavalier lead to one. You can tell the Cavs there right around that perimeter. They advance into the forecourt, out of the timeout. They'll send it all the way back to Caris LeVert. So the shot clock is off. LeVert bounces off to Mitchell. Cavs will play keep away here. Dallas looks for a steal. Garland, he's tackled. Whoa, by Green, nothing was called. And the Cavs take a timeout. Oh, my goodness. A tackle. Mobley to inbound. The Mavs look to deny. Whoa, that ball's knocked out of bounds. Mavericks ball. Again, the Cavs were out of timeouts. Dallas will use a timeout here.
In this situation, you can't have anybody get an easy shot.
Kleba has that tip by Mobley, but Doncic gets it back. Doncic dumps inside Washington, puts it in. 2 seconds left. The Cavs are out of timeouts. They have to go 94 feet. Strus from midcourt. Oh! Do you believe this?
Whoa! My goodness!
Max Strus from midcourt has won it for the Cavaliers.
The Cavaliers call up heaven for a prayer and is answered by Supermax.
Max. 44 points last night, 16 in the fourth quarter, and looking for his first basket here tonight in the fourth. The team is just 4-for-14 this quarter. Edwards got weight on him defensively. Settled for the three. He'll get it back and get another look. Short again. Conley. Another opportunity. Reed, good reposition on the perimeter for three.
There is no shortage of confidence with Anthony Edwards as he let those two fly. But Mike Conley, the veteran, 17 years, understand that Naz Reed has been the best three-point shooter on the floor tonight and finds the hot hand.
29 on 6 of 9 from downtown.
Two minutes
to go. Okoro drops it off for Allen for the flush.
Make that 4 of 11 when Rudy Gobert is contesting. That time would not be denied. Left no room for questions by Jared Allen, but a great pass by Okoro.
Conley looked like they had a look for Gobert. Couldn't get it to him, and now Edwards finds Rudy. Same result at the other end.
So both of these teams have tremendous penetrators, guys that can create off of the bounce. And then the help, Rudy Gobert or Jared Allen respectively, are coming to that penetration, leaving either big available on the back end for a smart pass.
Garland uses the Allen screen, circles back. 5 on the shot clock. Garland, LeVert, 3, no. Chance for Minnesota to take the lead.
Defense!
Edwards. Reed spins into the lane and around and down. Naz Reed, a new career high. He's got 31, and it's a one-point lead, final minute.
Have a day, Naz Reed. Jaden McDaniels has the second lowest field goal percentage of those that he defends.
Garland step back, in and out, rebound Edwards.
Wow.
Second best defense in the league needs a stop. Edwards steps back. And Gobert gets tangled up inside with Allen, and it's a foul on the T-Wolves.
Jared Allen just being active has been so big in the second half of this ball game.
And a technical foul has just been called, I believe, on Gobert.
Wow, what a swing. All right, so Rudy Gobert makes the money sign at the official.
At the official.
Oh, no. Don't want to insinuate that.
Garland makes the free throw. Gobert has fouled out. Okoro to inbound.
Without Gobert on the floor, Minnesota defenders have to keep the primary penetration in front of them.
Garland coming for it. Okoro to set the screen. Five on the shot clock. Darius going to work on Naz Reed. And it's blocked by Reed. Scramble for the loose ball. And it's a shot clock violation.
Keeping the guy in front. Jaden McDaniel, one of the best defenders on ball in the league. Naz Reed, though, no slouch in his own right. His versatility guarding multiple positions up at the level of the screen, keeping Garland a couple of steps back of the three-point line and then using his length could not have been defended better.
Now tonight he's got a career-high 31 points, a huge defensive play, just like the Edwards block last night.
They got three guys behind the ball.
Anderson will inbound, Allen defending. Edwards has it across midcourt, and Okoro gets that foul to give. 2.2 to go.
Very smart by the Cavs.
And I think the T-Wolves will use another timeout.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be their final.
I like the way that play was about to unfold, but smart by Okoro to use the foul. Personally, Beth, I'm not fouling here. I'm going to defend and hold. Hold on to my, trust my defense. Trust my top-rated defense in the league.
2.2 seconds to go here.
All right, and they've switched it up. Still going to look for some movement, I imagine, though.
Okoro defending Edwards to the right side of your screen. Anthony's got it. Shot up.
They run a little away action for Powell. Comes off for three. Good call by Ty Lue. He's got 11.
He can percolate in a hurry now. It feels like he's got his motor running. I thought he got fouled on that earlier mid-range he hit.
Green might have got him a piece. Van Vliet with a little get back. Couldn't get it. But another opportunity for the Rockets. 10 on the shot clock. Van Vliet draws the foul before the shot on Plumlee, and that will be his fourth personal foul. Going to be interesting to see if Ty Lue goes small or not down the stretch like he did in the Milwaukee game. And of course, things were complicated by the fact that the Bucks gave the Clippers problems with his own defense.
Well, we saw Paul George, I think, in the first half on Şengün be a difficult matchup for somebody.
Green sidestep three.
Boy, halfway down and up. Van Vliet. That rims out. Boy, two really good looks. Failed to fall. And the Clippers with a chance to knock the game up at 108. Kawhi fires. And we are tied at 108. Leonard with 25.
He is so tough. You can't speed him up. Just dances, lulls you to sleep a little bit. Wow.
He's having a big fourth quarter here. Şengün out front against Plumlee. Whistle, foul going to be called against Plumlee. That will be a blocking foul.
Let's watch Kawhi Leonard do some work. We opened the show talking about vintage, dangerous Kawhi. One-on-one, just lulling Jabari to sleep, thinking, I'm going to use my dribble to just get my space. Ooh, Clippers, I mean, Rockets look like they came out in a little zone.
Is that a hack of Plumlee we're doing now?
Wow.
Foul's going to go against Thompson. Off ball. I didn't see who he fouled on that play. Our view slightly obstructed, but and they do it again. They foul Plumlee. So they're, yes, they. I did. I was right. It was the hack of Plumlee strategy.
You got to do it now.
Going to put him at the free throw. Yeah, you got to do it before 2 minutes.
Exactly right.
Number 44, Mason Plumlee will go to the free throw line. Shoots his free throws left-handed. When he was in Charlotte, he broke his right hand, and assistant coach Jay Triano said, you know, your form is very good with your left.
Yeah.
Why don't you try shooting with your left? Ty Lue blinks and pulls Plumlee out of the game and maybe goes small. On the roll, Şengün blocked by Plumlee. Has an answer at atones at the defensive end. Harden. Leonard. Sprays it out to the corner for the lead. George got it. Splash. Paul George with 18, and the Clippers lead for the first time since it was 7-5 in their favor.
Got to respond here if you're this young team.
Harden switches on to Van Vliet. Plumlee is fronting Şengün. Couldn't get him the ball. Green stranded out top against Paul George. Underneath Smith, missed the layup.
And you see why Plumlee's still in the basketball game. Made the block, prohibits the catch.
Leonard, little machine gun dribble. The midi, and one! Kawhi not! Got hit on the elbow.
Missing some shots, some open looks that were definitely kind of favors for the Bucks, but got that one to go.
Dame steps it back, sinks the shot, cuts the lead to three. He's the one starter that's logged a ton of minutes tonight.
He has, and we are approaching clutch time in about 5 seconds. And there's no doubt the Bucks have got a lot on the line, 5-0. 3 second call.
Yeah, defensive 3 second call. Bobby Portis says, my bad, that's me. Back to the Dame Lillard three.
It's what makes this game just so beautiful is the ability of some of these guys to just make spectacular plays down the stretch when it matters. You're thinking, I'll make the responsible play. They'll move the ball. No, Dame Lillard is special. Paul George, special. It just made one on the other end, but missing that big free throw.
There actually hasn't been many defensive 3 second calls in the fourth quarter. And it's something that the Bucks assistants have talked to this team about, but we got one there, but no harm, no foul. Missed the free throw. Timeout is called, 5:02 left to go in this one. So another clutch game situation. Clippers are 17-12 in clutch games. The Bucks are 19-10. Those 19 wins are tied for second most in the league this year. Powell's in trouble, had to just toss it up, and it'll be a shot clock violation. Brook Lopez back in the game. So Brook and Bobby, Pat Bev, Dame, and A.J. Green. Two timeouts remaining for both these teams. P- Kapev has multiple three-point makes, and that one is the biggest one for him tonight. Make it three threes on the night and 12 in the game.
And he has been cold-blooded since he got to this Milwaukee team. He's out there talking trash. Told the United Center fans that was his home court last game. He's out here making shots, playing D. Look at him.
Forcing a turnover. Bobby gets it out to Dame. Chance to take the lead. Dame off the glass for two. And the Bucks have climbed all the way back and lead for the first time since the first quarter.
Both teams, you want an excuse? Well, it's a back-to-back for the Clippers. The Bucks, Giannis is out. Neither team's making an excuse right now, but now it's winning time.
Burke hits the block. Oh, things have shifted. The Bucks on an 8-0 run. They trail by as many as 15 at one point. Dame gets it right back. Inside 4 minutes. A.J. Green, it's a deep one. It's a deep one! A.J. automatic!
Is that A.J. Green or is that Steve Kerr? Is that Dame or is that Jordan out there?
The distance shot. 101 to 96.
You can't keep winning, and you can't keep making big fourth quarter plays, and it'd be a fluke. This team is playing such good basketball after All-Star. See what they got here to close.
8 seconds on the shot clock. They can't miss. Oh, the tide has turned.
Lisa, I'm a little bit speechless. This team has been impressive to watch since All-Star, but what they just are putting together, there's still a lot of time left.
Kuminga has completely changed the way Golden State looks at this season as Brown connects again on a three. 13 in the first quarter for Jaylen Brown.
Well, and I think Kuminga has earned that right to say those things. He is an NBA champion. He was contributing on this team since he has shown up. But sometimes to take your game to the next level, as Jaylen Brown knocks down another three and having some words with Draymond Green, I think Kuminga's growth was more of understanding the little things. It's not your talent. It's not your ability. It's like, can I make the right plays at the right time? Am I moving when I need to? Am I following the defensive assignments? Those are things that take time to really implement themselves in a player's career.
Brown, you bet! Jaylen Brown is scorching hot in this first. 19 points and already 5 made threes. And an offensive foul on Payton as Golden State turns it over.
And I said I was a little curious about the dare shots that Draymond Green was offering up to Jaylen Brown. And here we are. Once he gets going, once that rhythm is going, now you have yourself a very big problem. Sometimes percentages can be deceptive because players take tough shots or players are asked to be in difficult positions. But when you give a person an opportunity to say, hey, tee up a couple of shots, when they get that rhythm, it could be a problem.
That turnover was the first for either team. Here is Brown elevating. Back iron, no. Trace Jackson Davis into the game along with Chris Paul off the bench with Payton, Curry, and Quiñones. And a foul here will be against Boston. Derek White picks up his first. White out there with Hauser, Cornett, Brown, and Horford. Jaylen Brown with 19 points in this first. 6 of 11 from the floor, 5 of 8 from 3.
And there's still 4.5 minutes to go.
And you're right, Rich. Right out of the gate, Draymond Green was just daring him to shoot. And he says, all right, I will. And he's caught fire. Quiñones, nifty little split of the double, but could not finish it. Here's Derek White. Hauser's 3 is good. Boston. With 9 threes in the quarter, it's a 12-0 Celtics run. Curry hawked. Quiñones' 3, rims off. Hauser, nice box out there of Jackson Davis. Celtics cooking. White leaves it in. Cornet flushes. Timeout, Golden State, a 14-0 Celtics run. Meanwhile, the Celtics have 9 made threes, tied for their most in any quarter this season. Golden State's defense has been outstanding since the start of February, third best defensive efficiency in the NBA, but the Celtics carving them up without Kristaps Porzingis today as a defensive 3 seconds is called against Boston. Porzingis dealing with quad contusion. When Porzingis does start, the Celtics 26-5 this season when they have their starting five intact with Holiday, White, Brown, Tatum, and Porzingis.
Well, I like this, the kind of lineup changes, and you got to give Steve Kerr a lot of credit. Having tough conversations with Hall of Fame players, talking with young players, getting them engaged, bringing along, you know, a rookie like Brandon Podziemski to really contribute to this team. So this has not been the normal Golden State Warriors situation.
Right, dealing with slightly different starting lineups than normal today.
Yeah, getting Chris Paul, telling him to come off the bench, having that conversation with Klay coming off the bench for the first time in 12 years. So there's been a lot of difficult moments that Steve Kerr is navigating.
Jackson Davis, outstanding rejection. Brown, another three, rims off. And Jackson Davis, the rebound. Here comes Thompson. Kuminga back in. Jackson Davis, the handoff. Paul, fourth game back from injury. Chris Paul's mid-range, too strong. And Brown, the board for Boston. And a whistle underneath as Cornette hit the deck. Second team foul against Golden State. Quiñones gets whistled for his first personal.
That was a good hip check, a little bit of an embellishment.
Yeah, you're gonna get called for that.
Yeah, it's the right call.
Jaylen Brown gets a nice hand there as he checks out for the first time with 19 points. Here's Tatum. Holiday thought about it. Behind the back, lobbing it up. Oh, my. Ambitious attempt from Cornette, and he gets fouled.
Well, and we talked about it earlier. The Boston Celtics, number one in first quarter points, number two in second quarter points. So can you withstand this initial rush, this initial burst by the Boston Celtics? The Golden State Warriors, they have to settle in on the defensive end, figure out how they're going to guard this three-point. And I don't know if there is an answer because no team has been able to answer it thus far this year.
Celtics not only 47-12, they are 28-3 at home. Hauser can't hit. Cornette, a bear of a rebound and a whistle. Against Golden State, Luke Cornette wreaking havoc on the offensive glass right now. Fourth team foul, so side out of bounds again for Boston. Golden State's been a really strong rebounding team this season as well. Third in total rebounding percentage. Although no Podziemski, who's been a big part of their success on the glass. Here's Tatum. Flips it in, Jason Tatum with his first points of the game.
And that's the one, they use it with Porzingis, who's not playing. They post him up at the free throw line area often, one of the most efficient players in the league in that area. But you almost wish Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown would post up a little bit more because it gives them an option. No one's going to double team, not when you got guys shooting the ball like that.
Holiday unable to hit. He is shooting it at 45% this season, and now a foul against Boston off the rebound.
And again, with so many switching in today's league, look at this. Kuminga's not helping. There's no way. He gets all the way to the help of, or all the way to the rim before there's any sort of resistance. A lot of it is because you're guarding so many good three-point shooters that you don't want to dig down on a two-pointer and give up an open three.
A 37-22 Boston lead. Kuminga, back iron, no. He's been shooting way fewer threes during this stretch where he's been playing so much better and just concentrating on getting to the rim. Here's Tatum. Creeping inside, followed by Thompson. 10 to shoot. Tatum backing into Thompson, fading away. Didn't have enough on it. Kuminga slithers inside, can't finish it. And now Pritchard pushing pace for Boston. Here's Pritchard on the finish. And a delay of game warning against Boston. Curry on the bench was questionable to play this game with right knee bursitis. He is 0 for 4 from 3, 1 of 6 from the floor. Golden State is a team 3 of 11 from deep, and Boston on an 18-1 run. Jackson Davis gets denied by Cornette. 2 for 1 opportunity for the Celtics. Pritchard connects on a 3. 10th of the quarter for Boston. Their most in a single frame this season. A 21-1 Celtics run. Shot clock down to 5. Paul, nothing doing this possession. Paul gets denied by Tatum.
Just elite defense. Not enough movement there from the Golden State Warriors.
Holiday flips it up and in. Flawless artistry from the Boston Celtics to finish this first.
So they get one more challenge. Reeves in the front court. Reeves finds Hachimura. Corner three-pointer. Shot won't go. Rebound taken away. Davis took it right out of Jokic's hands. Reeves skirts through the paint. Tries again. Goes at Murray. Tough fall-away shot.
Got it!
Austin Reeves with a difficult shot, and the Lakers go up by 3.
I said it, Mike. Last 12, 13 games, his level, they feel different when he's playing like this.
Lakers shooting 54%. Reeves is 7 of 10. Jokic goes at Hachimura, kicks it out in the corner. Justin Holiday hits a 3. Holiday 11 points off the bench. We're tied again with 4.5 to play. Each team with 30-plus assists. Some great unselfish team basketball tonight. Reeves to James. James powers inside. Banks it home. Oh, what a shot from LeBron James.
And they are just spamming this high pick and roll between Austin Reeves and LeBron James. If they can't stop it, keep going to it.
You know he scored over 40,000 points. Holiday on the drive, kicks it back out, Gordon. Gordon, corner three. That's good! Aaron Gordon from downtown.
Wow. Mike, he was not close on his first three-point attempts.
He's shooting 29% from that distance for the season. Reeves to James, right back to Reeves, long three-pointer. Rebound to Reddish. And a ball off Jokic's foot. James drives, lost it, knocked out of bounds. And they say James lost it. James saying it was deflected, but it's a half-hearted argument, so I think he realizes he lost it. Points, 11 assists for Murray. Into the hands of Jokic, guarded by Hachimura. Jokic gets in the paint, turns, twists, flips it up, shot is good. He's got 33.
It's a ridiculous finish. And the touch is just absurd. It doesn't matter if he's twisting left shoulder, right shoulder.
Hachimura, elbow jumper. Off the mark, rebound Murray. Double team, good harassment there by the Lakers. Holiday getting some big fourth quarter minutes. Again, no Contavious Caldwell-Pope tonight. Murray looking. Shot clock at 5. Murray spins, turns. Jumper's good. Jamal Murray with 22, and Denver's lead is 5. This equals their largest lead of the game.
What a luxury to have if you're the Denver Nuggets to not
have just one guy, but two guys who can self-create like Jokic and Murray.
Davis shot blocked. Jokic right there, and he had some help as Gordon brings it into the front court. Holiday fakes. Holiday drives. Scoop layup. Banks at home. And it's a seven-point lead. They've scored nine in a row.
This ability to get timely stops and keep your foot on the gas on the offensive end. This is the gear that the Denver Nuggets can hit.
Reeves to Davis. Step back jumper.
Got it.
Anthony Davis, a big bucket, cuts it to five. Anxious moments for the Laker faithful. It happened so many times in the conference finals. Close games. The Nuggets made all the big plays down the stretch. Murray gets inside and banks it in. Sensational move from Jamal Murray. And a lead back up to seven. So the starting five on the floor for Darvin Ham. James fires away a three-pointer way off. And Porter with his 10th rebound throws it ahead to Gordon. And Gordon will bring it back out. It's gone quiet here at the Crypto.com Arena.
And if you're the Nuggets, there's no reason to do anything else but this two-man game right here. This is your bread and butter.
Murray, step back, three-pointer. Shot won't go. Gordon with the rebound. Big offensive board. They go inside to Jokic, and he banks it in. How about Porter recognizing the mismatch? And the lead is nine, largest of the game for the Nuggets. Under a minute remaining. James goes down a lane. Eurostep banks at home, and it's back to seven. Murray calmly walks it up the floor, despite the pressure from Reeves. Jokic hands it back. Jokic tips it to himself, backs in, flips it up. Oh, what a pass, and Gordon throws it down, and a foul. Looked like it was one of those flip shots from Jokic. Instead, a beautiful assist, and the lead is nine.
Time on the money.
His decision-making is just sheer brilliance.
Savant. This is what we call a basketball savant.
And many in the crowd now heading for the exits. As Denver with a 10-point advantage. What a fourth quarter from the Denver Nuggets. Reeves misses badly. Rebound. And that's going to do it. The Denver Nuggets remain perfect since the All-Star break. This will be six wins in a row. And here in the fourth quarter, they shoot 15 for 22 from the field. And beat the Lakers for the third time in three tries this season. LeBron James had his moment early. Much respect for the two future Hall of Famers as James passed the 40,000 career point mark. They couldn't get it to go with Jones, and they push it back up and in. How about that? Irving stuck with it and picks up his seventh point. It's Booker, intercepted, picked up by Kyrie Irving, puts on the brakes, three is in.
And rhythm three there by Kyrie. Comes up with the steal, knocks down the three.
Okogie goes inside and kicks it outside, and Royce O'Neal, Eubanks, and a turnover. Six now, three, Irving, got it!
Oh, okay, Kyrie!
Three, Pajemski got on the deck. An extra opportunity for the Dubs. And Steph from deep drops in a three.
Let's watch the Warriors' second chance points, because that's one of the areas defensively.
Amazing offenses, so does Detroit, so does Indiana. Steph Curry's amazing too, hitting another three.
Well, he's off to a great start tonight. It's going to be a scoring game for Steph. Off that split action, got pretty good screen, just enough separation.
Nembhard off back iron, Kuminga with the rebound. Two of the top six scoring teams in the NBA. Wiggins getting downhill again.
Pojimski set a little rough screen there. It was the ball movement. Kuminga start came off the ball screen, kicked it. So give them a taste of their own medicine.
Halliburton, nice find. Neesmith cutting and finishing. Not just a three-point shooter. He was acquired in that Brogdon trade. Boston really liked him. And Indiana signed him to an extension in the summer.
And they're moving without the ball, too, just like the Warriors want to play.
You saw the strength of Siakam there, but Turner fouled Draymond on that rebound.
Well, Neesmith, we're talking about him. It's interesting. He was the same guy they asked about his shooting. He was like, I'm an absolute sniper. And now he's shooting 46% from three-point range. He kind of had a slow start to his NBA career shooting-wise, but he shot 52% in his last year at Vanderbilt. I mean, the guy is a marksman.
Jalen Smith, 10th pick by Phoenix in the 2020 draft, the 2 years at Maryland, as he checks in. Steph, another three.
Come on now.
So Steph has started 3 of 3. Quiñones can guard.
He can. Halliburton is scoreless right now, but he's assisting a ton.
Moses Moody's first playing time. Good to see Moses get healthy on this trip. Steph just hit that from South Bend. His four threes here in the first quarter.
He got him. Neesmith with his hand down.
Siakam. Yeah, are you kidding me? You've got the Pacers 5 of 6, the Warriors 5 of 7 on threes.
I think it's safe to say this could be a high-scoring game.
Draymond!
Everybody's making quick decisions. Defenders jump out at Steph. He's making the right pass.
Indiana's the fourth-best three-point shooting team in the NBA. The Warriors are ninth. I'll tell you what, you've just got points aplenty here. And Benedict Mathurin, who had had a stomach issue the last couple games, he could score in bunches, too.
He comes in and picks up where everybody else left off.
Oh, Steph's 5 for 5!
He's putting on a show here.
Half of the Warriors' 30 points. Halliburton back on the kickout. They wanted Jalen Smith on Quiñones. He wouldn't let him get the ball. Shot clock at 7. Mathurin from the elbow. And charged with the rebound. When Steph's this hot, keep feeding him. Oh, Saric couldn't quite collect it. It was the right idea. And here comes that Indiana pace as Mathurin will get to the line.
Stephen Curry is a flamethrower. So that's why they had to jump out, send two defenders at him in the last possession. But working off this ball screen, Smith is just not close enough. And that trigger is way too... You've gotten a few stops, and you're scoring so well on your side. That's how you're getting a tiny bit of separation. Oh, my goodness.
Come on! 6 for 6! He's barely across midcourt!
He's a monster.
Oh, Siakam will flip it in and draw another foul. What is Curry doing?
This man is an animal. Two defenders all over him. They thought they had him hemmed up. But that's Stephen Curry.
Knicks looking for their first lead since the first quarter.
Yeah, the biggest lead has been 1 point.
Brunson runs into McBride, 7 on the 24. Brunson backs in. Scoop layup, it's up, it's good! And the Knicks take the lead.
5 consecutive points now for Brunson.
It's another Brunson barrage. It's 93-91. 34 points. Buddy Hield can't hit. Hartenstein is 13th rebound.
Hield misses last 2 3 balls.
This crowd is bonkers right now.
So is Brunson. He's running amok.
Brunson drives, pulls up, jump shot, got it! Jalen Brunson, born to play basketball. It's a 4-point lead.
Brunson, a right elbow three ball. Spinning and winning in the paint. And now stopping and popping again. Igniting, delighting, exciting this crowd. So Brunson, infallible, indomitable. Incredible again with another 34-plus performance.
Real star of the night, Jalen Brunson, once again. No Halliburton, and by the looks of it, I don't think he's going to come back in the game. Siakam, again, he's on a minutes restriction. Neesmith, Hart harassing him, and a foul.
To deny his penetration.
Nimhard.
Nimhard in his office in the paint.
Turner's being guarded by Deuce McBride. Neesmith shot, missed it. Rebound deflected, and a loose ball foul against Turner.
Again, the good defense. Neesmith's forcing up a shot. Hartenstein doing a good job harassing him. The Knicks will bring it up.
Five fouls on Turner. Rick Carlisle looking like he's going to have to go down the stretch without his all-star point guard. Brunson guarded by Nimhart. There's the double team. McBride kicks it to Achiuwa. Pressures Achiuwa left-handed. No good. Hartenstein right there with the follow.
Hartenstein rising and surprising him. Nobody blocking him out.
12 straight points. Knicks by six. Nimhart jump shot short. Hartenstein just dominating the boards.
Early on, Nimhart was feasting with the mid-range jumper. Not that time.
Brunson brings it back out. McBride fires away. And another loose ball foul. This time Achiuwa drawing the foul as Nesmith will pick up his fifth personal. Eight on the 24. Into the hands of Jalen Brunson. Five on the 24. Gets away from the double team. Kicks it out in the corner. Achiuwa has to put it up. Just gets it off in time. Off the side. Hartenstein keeps alive. Brunson a three. Achiuwa, another follow. Won't go. Rebound, Shepard.
Brunson had time, folks. He rushed that last shot. No reason to rush it. Look at the time remaining.
Siakam pulls back. Under 3.5 left. Siakam up top. Jalen Smith lines up the three and rattles it in. It's amazing. A big man shooting 47% from downtown.
Yeah, he has 14 now off the bench. He likes straight on with the hoop.
That's the Pacers' first points in over 5 minutes. Hart the drive, slips, and is fouled. They might challenge that. It looked like he slipped on a wet court and not necessarily a trip.
So he's doing his job, bringing the intangibles as he needs to make these two free throws.
Misses the first. By the way, the Pacers scored 36 points in the first quarter.
23 points.
Hart goes 1-for-2. Knicks up 4. 3 minutes remaining.
Nick D has been up for the challenge. Siakam, silent night.
Siakam pulls back. Kicks it back up top. Smith now chased off the three-point line. The running shot. Count it and one. Achiuwa tried to draw the foul, but was not in good position. And a chance for a three-point play for Smith.
Previous Smith straight on with the hoop with a three ball. This time duping and hooping.
They're going to challenge that.
Upon review, the challenge is unsuccessful. Defender never gets struck in the path. Play stance. As a blocking foul, we're going to shoot one shot.
And he's distinguished himself tonight. He's been a lethal shooter behind the arc, but 15 feet away, he misses.
Knicks have three players in double figures in rebounds. Hartenstein 16, Achiuwa 13, Hart 11. Hart the drive out to DiVincenzo. DiVincenzo the floater in the paint. Well short. Achiuwa the rebound back up and he's fouled. With 2:29 remaining.
Give Achiuwa one more rebound. 14. Bounding and astounding.
The Knicks are shooting 39% from the field, 22% from three. But a big part of this game is the rebounding in the second half. That's the seventh offensive rebound for Achiuwa.
And he's a poor free throw shooter. Look at on this season, only 60%.
And comes up short there. For his career, he's only at 60%. Last year, he shot a career high 70% for the Raptors.
Needs to get this one down.
Knicks have missed 5 free throws. Achiuwa connects on the second. It's back to 3.
Got to watch Smith. He's been their nemesis. There he is.
He finds Siakam guarded by Achiuwa. They know each other well. The former teammate Siakam pull up jumper's good. And it's a 1-point game.
Siakam 15 feet away with the jumper.
18 points for Siakam. Brunson falls down. Got poked in the eye. Smith takes it away and throws it down. No call.
So Brunson got hit in the forehead. And just lost it. I guess he was stunned.
Boy, the crowd is furious. Some full court pressure here. DiVincenzo will bring it up. Under 2 minutes remaining. Knicks now down by 1. They led by 6.
Oh.
Dangerous pass. Brunson gets it back. Shot clock at 10. Brunson drives. Foul. Shot is up. Count it. And one. Jalen Brunson with another answer. And the Knicks are back up by one.
We've seen this type of tenacity from Brunson. The pugnacious play. Indomitable spirit showing it right here as he's energizing. Crowd on their feet chanting MVP. You can see under the basket there. Now you can hear like at a...
Ooh. Hartenstein the tip, gets it back, kicks it out. And DiVincenzo will set it up.
Hartenstein another bound, folks. 16 for the night.
DiVincenzo the drive, pulls up, jump shot, puts it in.
Again, the perseverance by the Knicks.
Nimhard to Smith.
They want Siakam.
Chance of defense from the Garden crowd. Siakam drives. Layup blocked by Achiuwa. Knocked loose. Picked up by Brunson. Hield is shaken up. Hield is down. Knicks have 5-on-4. Hield is hurt. Brunson shake and bake. Kicks it back out. DiVincenzo, three-pointer. Achiuwa tips it up and in. Timeout Pacers. Bedlam here at the Garden.
Heroes abound tonight for the Knicks, folks. Obviously, it's been Brunson heroics, but what about Hartenstein? 18 rebounds, two shy of his career high, and Precious previously blocking the shot. Remember, Precious blocked the shot of Siakam, and then watch the quantum leap here, the left side of your screen, but it's tip in. So, stupendous play by Precious, igniting the Knicks down the stretch.
He's fifth in the league in block shots, 2.5 per game.
Curry fakes, resets, and hits. Three-pointer, Steph Curry, his fifth.
It just gets that defender reacting. He gets you either off balance, turned around, sometimes both of those things.
So 19 for Curry to lead all scores. Reeves to Anthony Davis. Jump shot, bounces around a bit. A rare miss tonight for Davis. He's 7 of 9 from the field. Kuminga and Green play catch. And Kuminga and Green both back in the starting lineup. Thompson the drive. Wiggins drives on Russell. And Russell on the reach in. Free throws for Wiggins, second on Russell.
Darvin Ham talking about multiple efforts. He's just going to get Austin Reeves on skates. Little up fake. There's the challenge. He's going to recover. Like, you can't stop if you're Austin. He tries to scramble back out. But the elite footwork of Steph Curry, he talks about those mini improvements, efficiency of movement, making sure I'm reacting with the ball, without the ball. Am I minimizing my physical exertion? That's a prime example of that.
He'll be 36 in a couple of months. This is his 15th year. And the thing, and this goes for LeBron James and Curry, Kevin Durant, you know, some of these great players who've accomplished so much and are later on in their career, they're still so hungry to win, and they still play with such joy.
Love it. I love that they love to play and that they're still seeking improvement.
And an offensive foul. Draymond Green applauds the call. As Dorian Prince, not agreeing with it, picks up his third foul.
A totally different feel from Draymond Green. We've not seen, as he termed it, any of the antics. He's a little bit frustrated here because he thinks that Prince is being allowed to be too physical, but clap and get back down. So he's done a good job.
Fakes the handoff, throws it into Kuminga. Kuminga likes the matchup. Now it's doubled. Wiggins, that leaves him wide open, and knocks down the three. Perhaps part of the growth of Kuminga, not trying to force it, and he gives his teammate an open look.
Unequivocally, his willingness to move it and make quick decisions.
Shot blocked by Green. Kuminga, open floor, drives and finishes. Timeout Lakers. A 10-0 run from Golden State. And this equals their largest lead of the game.
His return.
That's 12 years as teammates, those two. Davis gets inside. Shot bounces around. Curry grabs the rebound. Gets in the paint. Drives all the way.
off the glass. So 21 for Curry.
Sorry, Mike. He's guarding Anthony Davis, makes that a tough shot, and then sets that little screen in the paint. Incredible.
12 straight points. James trying to answer with a three. Kuminga flies in for the rebound. Kuminga, six boards to go with the 17 points. What a pass there from Curry. Wiggins kicks it back up top. Curry launches a three. Tried to draw the foul. Here comes James. Flips it out. Reeves. Fake. Russell. Fake. One bounce. Three-pointer. It's good. Russell nails the three.
Excellent patience, Mike. And that felt like a big shot. Warriors were getting some rhythm to what they were doing.
A slow start to the third quarter for the Lakers. Thompson. No hesitation. Ball barely in his hand when he went into shooting form. His first three-pointer had been a struggle all night. Now 2 for 11 overall from the field. Nearly deflected, was. Goes out of bounds. Golden State ball.
I love the disposition that Golden State has started this period with.
What a start. 18-5 beginning here in the third. We're only 4.5 minutes into it. They've got 18 points already. Thompson kicks it out. Wiggins, clean look. Three-pointer in and out and in again. Wiggins with the three. The lead is ballooned. Double figures. First one of the night. Davis drives. Wiggins got a piece of it. Wiggins kicks it out. Thompson, one bounce, three-pointer, puts it in.
Giannis is terrorizing people right now, I feel like.
Beal on the drive to a wide-open Allen. Got it.
That'll help. I mean, if you're going to come back, this is the thing that changes the dynamic, right? The long-range shooting can get you back in a hurry.
Having a career year from deep. Williams with the floater. And Nurkic with another rebound. Suns looking for a run here. Beal with a show and go. And drew the foul on Gilgeous Alexander. And Beal pops up push-up style and will make that procession to the free throw line. Each team with two fouls. Beal with 21. And going to shoot two more. Beal still acclimating to life in the desert here in Phoenix. Mark Spears has allowed Beal to do a personal diary throughout the course of the year. Mark Spears, Hall of Fame writer from Anscape. And Beal in it talks about finally getting healthy in the latest episode and just getting comfortable in his new home here with his lovely bride and his three sons and his two Rottweilers. Plenty of room for the dogs, girls.
Always.
He's got good protection, folks. Joe with the sidestep three and another rebound for Yusuf Nurkic. He has 21.
So multiple stops. Now you got to just keep your foot on the gas and keep scoring.
Oh, great spray out to O'Neal. Nurkic with his 22nd board. Allen from deep. And Holmgren clears. And a couple of very good looks. Nice back tap by O'Neal on Williams to knock it out of bounds. 84-68, and it just feels like Phoenix hasn't been able to make up much ground.
No, it does not. I mean, they've forced some misses. Oklahoma City's had some good looks. I'll take a wide open Isaiah Joe three anytime.
Joe inside the three-point line with the midi.
They've proven to be too consistent a jump shooting team for that string to keep going there. The vibes of these two teams feels totally different to me.
On opposite ends of the spectrum.
Right? What is it that the young people say, like, the vibes are immaculate?
Yeah, not so much right now.
With OKC, they are.
Yeah. Kevin Durant trying to catch some good ones. We'll go to the line and try and complete the three-point play. That foul is going to go against Gilgeous Alexander. And the third team foul as a result on OKC.
So Bradley Beal goes out. Do you rest him this final 4:45? Try to make some inroads without him? Give the ball to Kevin Durant?
Yeah, Beal has played 23 minutes. George said that he was in range, or there's an upper range. Gilgeous Alexander in traffic, out of bounds. Little indecision, and we're going to have a jump ball as a result.
Official on the strong side didn't see it. Looks to her partner on the opposite end of the floor, opposite side of the floor, to see if that official had vision on it.
One of the few times you'll see him lose control in traffic with his extremely tight handle.
This is a break here for Phoenix, because that was off Royce.
15-point lead for the visitors. Holmgren, Joe does not hesitate. And Grayson Allen with the rebound. Eric Gordon with a quick snap drive. Tipped up and in by Nurkic. Lead is down to 13. Dort on the crossover. Knocked away by Allen. Wonderful defense by Grayson Allen. Durant cross court, one more. Gordon, catch.
Some life. After all those turnovers, back within 10. It's amazing when you start to string together stops. Excellent defensive play. Get down the other end. Keep trying to put some scores on. The three is changing the dynamic here.
Jusuf Nurkić trending towards a franchise high rebounding, which right now is held by the late, great Paul Silas.
Marquise brought a level of physicality that has changed the dynamic. 16-2 run here by Phoenix. They have four threes in that run.
Saben Lee adding a little bit of speed to the lineup. Missed the shot badly. Frank Vogel looking for a call. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Holmgren the trailer. And rebounded by Durant. Good screen by Eubanks. And Durant doesn't need much room.
Wow.
We've seen that over and over, Doris.
That's but Chet Holmgren getting a good contest on him.
Gordon Hayward on the baseline. Relocates. Hayward on the drive. Out to Lou Dort. Got his feet set. And Eubanks with the board.
That's where Gordon Hayward can help them, though. A veteran, savvy, gets a good look for his teammate there when you need it.
Eubanks! Oh, went high. And tried to take Gilgeous Alexander's soul away. He commits the foul. Fourth team foul on the Thunder. One more look.
So Kevin Durant, excellent, excellent feel for the game. And Mark, you go back to that play where there was the non-whistle of Nurkic hitting Chet Holmgren. Mm. The game has changed from that point forward.
Continue their West Coast trip against LeBron and the Lakers. Coverage begins with NBA Countdown at 7 o'clock Eastern.
So good response here by Phoenix. Really good response.
Oh, Gilgeous Alexander fouled by Saben Lee. And a perplexed look coming from Kevin Durant.
It looked like he pulled the chair out. That's Shai's move, right? He wants to get underneath the free throw line. And he's going to use the spin and try to create contact. Like, I don't know about that. That doesn't look like a foul. Looks like he lost control first.
Yeah, did pull the chair up. Gilgeous Alexander against Gordon this time. Good help by Allen. And they throw it into the backcourt. It was tipped. So no over and back violation. One to go. Dort with a 9-1-1. And rebounded by Eubanks. The lead is six. The Suns have fought their way back in. From the nail, Durant to Allen. Great fake. Seven on the clock for Lee. Durant saw two bodies. Lee inside. One more to Allen for three.
Making the young team feel game pressure, though, Mark. It's about execution here.
Dort. Short.
And out to Saban Lee. Durant on the move. Allen catch and shoot. Got it. And it's a three-point game.
Even for Scotty Barnes.
Brandon, how about a three?
Yes. How about it, Joe?
Man, what a night. He is now 4 of 6 beyond the arc, 12 of 16 overall, and up to 29 points, 9 assists, 6 boards. Pirtle. And after it again, but Larry. And Larry ripped it away. Larry.
Ripped it away twice.
Right, and Scotty Barnes was after it, who's a strong guy. Back to back.
Okay. Yes, sir. Clickety click.
Man.
Clickety click. Hand in the dice game.
2.5 to play. 32-point game. 13-1 run. And the run on the baseline at Warren. Not that time for Dick.
Brady Richards.
2:15 and counting.
Give it back to B.I. Go on and pull up.
Yeah. Here comes the double. You can't blame them. Although, don't walk. You're going to walk away from him? Jose.
One more.
Absolutely. How about a third triple? Yes!
Clickety-clack twice! Oh, clickety-clack, clickety-clack. Hand in the dice game. Shoot that thing, B.I.
35 for Brandon Ingram.
Actually, Larry is in the building. I see you, B.I.
Barnes wanted Pirtle, almost gave it away. Final 95 seconds. What a third for the Pels. And especially Brandon Ingram. That three will fall.
So no matter what, these is the rules, Joe. B.I. has to take this shot. Dems is the rules. I'm just telling you.
It's always a heat check, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's got to be. Scotty Barnes is going to be picked off.
Brandon. Going to pull up, B.I.
Beyond the arc.
Going to pull up.
From the pit.
Going to pull up.
But one
going
more.
To pull up.
One more. He's got 38. 7 of 9 on his threes. That is Young.
B.I. is on that grill. He is barbecuing today. Chicken wings. Man. Chicken wings. Salmon. Yeah. Cheeseburgers.
And he deserves it.
Hot dogs.
Listen to this crowd for Brandon Ingram.
Wow. That's 5 threes this quarter, Joe. So, you know the way the rules work, Joe. Who has to take the next shot?
It's automatic. He's not leaving the floor. 48 seconds left in the third. And 102 on the board already, thanks to Brandon Ingram's 38. One more. Tries it. Gets it! Incredible! 41 for Ingram.
This place is exploded. Well let him rock.
It is
let him rock.
Loaded for him.
Let him rock.
Barnes tied up by Dice. And on the back tap, they're going to come a foul. His career best, 49 points. This is his season high of 41.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Brandon Xavier Ingram.
4 minutes left. Curry answers. He ties it. Steph's got 42.
Let's get a little back and forth going here. Crowd's all into it.
Kuminga taking a turn on Trae Young.
This is must-see TV.
He gets Clay on the switch. Two men jump at him. Trae Young right to the rim.
New Draymond wasn't really going to challenge him there. That's the thing. If you double-team, you got to try to keep him contained. He got around that double-team.
Two guys at Curry. Three on the way. Got another one!
Come on now.
45 for Steph.
Steph's saying, I'm with it. Let's go. They get a double-team Trae.
They got it out of Trae Young's hands. Jalen Johnson on the attack. Jalen Johnson put it up and out. Rebound. Draymond fought for it. And Clay pulled it.
Give the game breaker the ball.
How hot is Steph Curry? All the way down the lane to lay it up and in.
Everybody thinks he's going to shoot a three. He can do that too.
47.
He's so big time.
Two men jumping Trae Young. Kuminga recovered on him. Kuminga staying with him. Shot clock at 10. Kuminga's going to be called for a foul.
Just saying he hit him on the shoulder. Or just touched him on the shoulder. Coach Kerr is begging. Oh, my goodness. That just came out of nowhere. Look, he's just touching him. He's just kind of, yeah. You can't really do that.
Not three times.
He kind of overdid it there.
Fourth team foul. Next one will be free throws. Trying to deny. Kuminga did well, so Trae Young couldn't get the ball.
He's just trying to make him uncomfortable.
Bogdanović, baseline jumper. What a big shot.
Trae Young is not the only shot maker out there for the Hawks.
Bogdanović had been 2 of 12. He's hit his last three. Curry, three. Off iron there. Coming upon the 2 minutes of crunch time. DeJounte Murray to an open Jalen Johnson for the lead. No!
Crowd's oohing and on. Who can close this one out?
The Human Torch has 47 in the game. Curry off the handoff. Step back three. Good! A 50 ball!
The maestro. Okongwu had nothing for that. The best step back in the league.
100 seconds of crunch time. Trae Young into Okongwu. That's a good foul. Make him earn it at the line.
I don't know if Draymond had to come over that far to help. It's an easy dish for Trae Young. Watch Steph. He's going to give and go. Come off of that. The screen gets rid of DeJounte Murray. The Kongwu. That step back creates so much separation.
12 minutes to go.
Jonesy, third quarter. SGA has accounted for 26 of the 37 points scored.
Wow. Andrea Carter, sideline talked about the adjustments that San Antonio had made in these now the second meeting against OKC. Micić missing from the wing. Holmgren hustling for the rebound. Here's the matchup we all want to see. He defers to Micić. Holmgren pulls the three. Got it. And he's into double figures now with 11.
I am very curious to see if Wimby gets to finish this fourth quarter.
Goes quick against Holmgren and slammed it home. Put his shoulder into Chet. Little bully ball.
They said it's rivalry week, Jonesy.
Oh, and that's going to be an offensive foul against Holmgren, who might have had payback on his mind a little bit. Let's take another look at Wembanyama's dunk.
Every action has an equal or maybe not equal reaction as Chet comes down and picks up a quick foul after that play.
Chet battling defensively, got the steal, and leads the break at 7-1. Holmgren with the lay-in. And a little payback for him. So this is where we are in 2024 then. 7'1" players leading the
point
fast
guard,
break.
Like full court one-on-one like it's a
feet,
drill.
Monica.
I mean, comes up with the steal, great position, and then just handles through the traffic. There's three white jerseys there. Wow.
Williams turns the corner. Good defense by Johnson. Wallace off glass, got it to fall.
I love the line that Coach Dagnall gave us in regards to Cason Wallace, who's having a terrific year out of Kentucky. He said he's so functional, we don't want to lose sight of the upside that he has, which I think is a great compliment.
Still got a high ceiling that has yet to be approached. Here's Wiggins in transition, hops through the lane and scored it.
He a Terp, Andrew Wiggins out of the University of Maryland. Shout out to my home region,
you say
hometown.
That when you said that.
You know what I'm saying? Even though I'm a Hoya, but you know, I got to give him his props.
He's switching it up. Vassell through the contact. Dagnall makes the call. 17 points in the ball game for him. Here's Williams off the Holmgren screen. Wembanyama switched onto him. Holmgren inside, slams it home. And Holmgren has turned up the intensity dial a little. Not sure who tipped that in, but Wembanyama's nodding his head like, yeah, that was me.
We're going to have to ask our statistician, Stevie, to keep track on the one-on-one that's breaking out here.
Micic around the Holmgren screen. Baseline drift by Williams. He rips through. Had it knocked away right to his teammate. And Micic walked with it. That's going to be a traveling violation. 14th turnover for the Thunder as Champagne comes in for Keldon Johnson. You know, Chet Holmgren, amongst other things, an exceptional teammate. Going back to his days at Gonzaga when he got a really healthy bag of NIL money, he split it up amongst all of his teammates.
Amazing.
And if you notice his post-game media sessions, as Wembanyama is going to have something to say after the game, Holmgren likes to invite his teammates to do all of his interviews.
Oh, man, Jonesy. He does. That is sort of iconic, and it speaks to the camaraderie of this OKC squad.
Micic dancing with it, sprays it out to Holmgren. Oh, he put the big man on a flight, got it back, and tipped it home. Holmgren up to 17 now. Wembanyama with 24, and Chet has 9 in this quarter. Young man that grew up on the south side of Minneapolis, hooping with his buddies and eating jerk chicken and rice and peas afterwards. And last week, they retired him. San Antonio trying to fight its way back in the ballgame, but a daunting challenge, down by 26. Branham with 9. Holmgren on the pick and pop.
Got the switch, you want it.
Spins a couple of times. Wiggins goes around the world. Tough fadeaway, got it.
You think he's been watching his teammate a little bit on that move? Looked very SGA-esque.
12 points of the ball game for him in this battle between the youngest team in the NBA, the Spurs, and the second youngest team in the league, the Thunder. Oh, Wimby tried to take his soul away. With audacity on the dunk attempt. Wiggins for 3, got it.
Oh my gosh.
Wembanyama with bad intentions that time.
Oh my gosh.
This is starting to get really spicy underneath. McDermott for 3, got it. Timeout on the floor.
Doesn't surprise me.
It's Jokic on top, approaching 3 to play. Lakers have never led. Denver's led by as many as 15. Shot clock at 7. Prince the defense. Jokic will feed. Walks and will slam. Pretty pass. Another assist. Jokic has got 7 of them.
And you just put him at that free throw line area where he can see where all the double teams are coming from.
Reeves has got it. He goes for Davis, who's picked up by Watson. Cross court, out of bounds, ricocheted away. 3.5 on the shot clock.
Look at all the eyes on Jokic. 4 of them. Nice job there by Watson to back cut on LeBron and get the finish.
What vision he's got. James to tie. 3, no. Murray, football pass down court. Watson was rejected by Hayes.
Yes.
Rejected by Jackson Hayes. In the corner, Prince takes it, feeds, Reeves, 3, good! We are tied!
If the Lakers find a way to win this ball game, Jackson Hayes better get the game ball.
2 minutes to play. Murray aligns his 3. Steely shot. 27 and 5 threes for Jamal Murray. Gordon comes out on James. Reeves a screen. There's a double screen by Hayes. And James inside. It's loose. Ah,
Murray climbs the ladder and gets the ball. The other way, fakes the pass and puts up the runner.
Why not?
Five in a row from Jamal Murray.
Well, he torched them in the playoffs a year ago, and he continues to haunt them.
29 points and 10 in the quarter for Jamal. It's Davis Reeves. Here's a three. Rebound Porter. Murray comes up with two gigantic baskets. A three and a two and five straight for Denver. Almost swiped there. Jokic corner. It's Porter a three.
And here's the problem. If you're Austin Reeves and you're going to gamble on a shooter on Jokic, he'll burn you if you don't get the steal.
The defending champs on an 8-0 run.
The league's best three-point shooters wide open.
Here's Reeves thinking three, maneuvering for two with the drive. Hits the deck, rebound Jokic, and that may do it. Eight-point game, Murray the other way. Hold on, Porter with the flush. And just like that, Denver's put this one on ice.
And it shows you their championship experience, right?
Wow. Bulldozing inside, LeBron for two. Stops a 10-0 run. And James with 25. Jokic is doubled. Out of the trap he goes. With a half minute to go, Denver looking to get their 36th win, which would put them atop the Western Conference. And alone with the second best record in the NBA and back of Boston.
It's not a 24-second violation because Anthony Davis stole the ball.
Here goes the inbound to LeBron. Davis will shoot a three. That's it. Seven consecutive wins for the Nuggets over the Lakers. That ends a little two-game losing streak on the road for the Nuggets. They've won now overall three straight, 5 of 6, and 8 of 10.
Davis gives it up immediately. Now a step back three. Got it! 8 threes for D'Angelo Russell. Timeout Milwaukee.
And that's the challenge, right? To continue to get Anthony Davis touches within the flow of offense so it doesn't have to be dead ball situations and for him to maintain that aggressive mindset.
And what's he capable of given how much pain he's in right now? Lopez rattles down a three and the Lakers back within two. Lopez is 3 of 3 from three-point range tonight. The first two came really early in the game, and we haven't called his name much since on offense, but very active on the defensive end. Downhill, Hachimura met in midair by Giannis with the rejection. And a foul called as Connaughton got knocked down by Davis. That's three on Davis, and the Lakers are over the foul limit.
What a play by Giannis at the rim. Hachimura thought he had an easy dunk, and Giannis said, I don't think so. I mean, that's just an outstanding individual defensive play.
Former Defensive Player of the Year back in 2020. And now Milwaukee shooting free throws for the final 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Pat Connaughton a chance to tie the game. But he missed the first free throw. Been struggling at the line this year, barely over 70%.
Timeout.
Darvin Ham's going to call a timeout. His team up two. Trying to blown out Wednesday at Golden State. Connaughton got the second one. Milwaukee trailing by one. Lakers have been the best clutch time team in the league this year. No LeBron James tonight, missing his 9th game of the season. Anthony Davis has clearly played injured throughout the quarter. Giannis with the jumper gives Milwaukee the lead. 32 points for Giannis, and it's the first Buck lead since early in the second quarter.
And Doc Rivers so good in those after timeout situations, getting shots that they want to make sure that they get opportunities.
Russell with the floater. That's 36 now for D'Angelo Russell.
Silky smooth. He is not rushed, and he is making every big play.
Giannis, Connaughton, good look, and
and he pays it off, swishing home a three. Milwaukee back in front by two with 2:20 left.
Four threes off the bench for Pat Connaughton. He's been big time for the Bucks.
Russell around the screen, lets it fly. No good on the three. Lopez rebounds. Bucks ball and a two-point lead. Giannis now with a triple-double, his eighth of the season, good for fourth in the league. 32 points, 14 rebounds, and 10 assists. Giannis gives it up to Lillard. Turn and fire. He's fouled, and it's good. A three by Dame, and a chance at a four-point play. Lillard so good at sensing where the defender is. He rises at the perfect time, makes it, and will go to the line.
And that's a tough shot. The ability to stay focused with somebody coming at your legs like that. But that's what Dame Lillard does. He makes tough shots in big moments.
27 points for Lillard. Fifth foul on D'Angelo Russell. Lillard completes the four-point play. 7 points for the Bucks in 30 seconds to take a six-point lead.
Well, now it's about getting a defensive stop.
Reaves driving into traffic. Hachimura gets a great look, and he drills a three. They needed it, and they got it from Hachimura, who's been so good of late. Lakers back within three. First three of the night, Hachimura had been 0-for-5. Giannis driving underneath. Connaughton, reverse layup, good. Another great find from Adetokounmpo. And Connaughton's been outstanding off the bench.
He absolutely
with 15.
Has. And the execution, time and score situation. The Bucks have slowed down. They've manipulated and gotten great shots.
Check that, 17 for Connaughton. On the switch, Lopez guarding Reaves. Davis, Russell, three. That's 9 threes for Russell. 39 points. Lakers back within two, a minute to go. Giannis sets the screen for Lillard. He drives to the corner, batted away. Russell will stay with Milwaukee, 11 to shoot.
My goodness, D'Angelo Russell. The extra pass. He knows he's got to get it off quickly. Right on the money.
Milwaukee with possession. 11 to shoot. Giannis. Now they switch. Dinwiddie's on him. Giannis spins past him underneath the basket. And a Laker foul. Darvinham may challenge that. The Lakers bench erupts in disapproval over the call. And Darvinham is going to challenge it. Boy, it did not look like much contact at all when the whistle blew. It's a two-point lead for Milwaukee.
It's been overturned to a no-count. Milwaukee player has possession of the basketball, so therefore Milwaukee will retain possession on either side in the deep corner. The shot clock will be reset to 4.2 seconds. L.A. will be granted their timeout back and also the opportunity for a second challenge.
Then you're going to get it to Giannis.
And again, you got Davis hobbling, favoring that left shoulder. Lillard caught in the air, finds Giannis, and he banks it in. As the shot clock expires, great heads-up play by Giannis. 34 points, Milwaukee by four.
By both. Dame knew he had both of them coming out.
Here's Russell with 39 points, drives the lane, flips it up and in. Count the basket and the foul, a three-point opportunity for Russell. Let's see if Doc Rivers challenges this foul called on Lillard.
Foul,
Dame is so good coming off of this handoff. He draws both defenders and Giannis heads up, understands the shot clock is getting skinny, goes off glass. And all day long, D'Angelo Russell has been playing with great pace. He's picked his spots, and that's a tough finish.
It looked like the right call. Doc will not challenge it. The free throw off the front rim and in. 42 points now for D'Angelo Russell. The Lakers without LeBron James. 42 points. They're going to have Giannis inbound, and Davis will guard the inbound pass. Now Lillard, defended by Reddish. Giannis sets the screen. Giannis rolls. Lillard keeps. Lillard draws Davis. Shot clock to 12. Lillard puts it on the deck. Past AD. Flips it up. No. Rebound Lakers. And a timeout by Darvin Ham. The Lakers can hold for the final shot. Lopez on the inbound of Hachimura. Beasley meeting Russell near midcourt. 15 seconds to go. Now on the switch, Lillard's got Russell with 12 seconds. Russell gets past Lillard with 7. Floater, good! Russell gives the Lakers a 1-point lead with 5.9 remaining. A 44-point night for D'Angelo Russell, who's on the low block. He'll come off a Giannis screen and get it near midcourt with 5 seconds. Lillard, step back, blocked by Dinwiddie! Loose ball!
Defending without fouling is going to be much tougher to do. Watch out for his pick-and-roll game with Vucevic, too.
Oh, what a beautiful out-of-bounds play to get Kuminga the dunk. Yeah. That was sweet. And Steve Kerr gets the assist.
And thank you, Steph Curry. Cross pass with him. DeMar DeRozan took a step out towards Steph. That's all it took.
Gave up 36 and 38 in the second and third quarters. And Curry draws the charge. And
Steph Curry stepped in there. Yeah, listen, you got Steph Curry coming out this way. Yeah, you get DeMar DeRozan taking a step out towards Steph. Kuminga's going to be at the basket pretty easy, but everybody's going to see that. Steph defending, too.
Draymond, that split action again. Curry, kick out Moody, catch and shoot 3. Batted back out, and Kobe White's got it.
Excuse me.
That will be the foul in the backcourt. And now Steph in a little distress.
They're in the bonus. You're going to get free throws.
That doesn't look good.
Yeah, Steph is limping around. That is the last thing you want to see. He's trying to work that thing out. See if we can find what happened to Steph. Going back door. Oh, there's a turn. The right ankle.
Turn that right ankle. Saw that so many times earlier in his career.
Took an awkward step.
And Kobe White dropping in the free throw. That's Barrymore. Steph. He's going to have to come out of the game and maybe go to the locker room.
Yeah, that's one. You can't just walk that one off and come back in the game. You wouldn't think.
So Steph leaves in a 1-point game. But concern is far beyond this game. Chris Paul in. Draymond attacking. Draymond's got a triple-double. His first one since December 20th, 2021.
That's big time. He's got to keep the defense honest. Vucevic went over to help against Clay. Tough help and recover if he's driving like that.
DeRozan missed the fourth quarter. Kobe White's made free throws, but can't make the three. And the rebound to Kuminga.
And there's Steph going back to the locker room.
That was a full yank on that right ankle. Clay flat with that three. And here comes DeRozan out of the pack. Single possession ball game at the 3-minute mark.
And how do you close out a game without one of your closers?
Kuminga knocked it away. Kobe White will retreat and get it. Vucevic had the hot hand all night. He buries a three. He's got 31.
It's that same pick and pop again. Warriors don't want to get a third defender in there to stunt it.
The Bulls are outscoring the Warriors by 21 points on the three-point line. 7 more made threes.
And it's weird because they're 22nd in attempts. They don't even rely on the three ball as much.
Draymond thought about that jumper. Clay, tough fade, fire in hands. That's vintage Clay Thompson right there. He's got 22 to lead the Warriors.
He's been the constant the whole game.
Defense in the fourth quarter has been much improved. But Chicago's not done. Vucevic again. This one off. Caruso kept it alive.
Got a running start. Got to put bodies on people. Stop their momentum.
And Kobe White. Isumu with the shot clock at 3. Vucevic again. Off iron. And Kuminga. Give me that rebound. Kuminga's got 9 pulls tonight.
What are you running now? Settle down, get something great.
100 seconds of crunch time. 2-point lead in the ball. Chris Paul gets Vucevic on a switch. Two men jump at him. Draymond three. He made two of them against Milwaukee in the fourth quarter last night, missing there. You know it's all DeMar DeRozan now. DeRozan against the world. He's going to take a turn on Moody. He makes him give it up. Shot clock at 10. Kobe White creating space and flips it in and ties the game.
That was pretty good defense from Clay. That's just a big-time shot.
13 ties, 19 lead changes. Warriors led by 13, Bulls led by 12. Final minute. Clay comes free, and it's going to be a moving screen on Draymond, and he's fouled out of the game.
Well, they're looking to see if they want to challenge this. You just said he fouled out. It's a big-time call. If they feel like they want to challenge, they're going to challenge this for sure, I think. Oh, no, they're saying no. Jacob Rubin is saying no.
So they're not going to challenge it. Steph is in the locker room with an injured ankle.
Yeah,
Draymond is fouled out of the game.
Draymond moved to his right a little bit. Watch. Just a little step towards. Yeah, there's a little bit too much there. You just want to make them go around you, stay stationary.
Well, Steve Kerr's kind of asking, like, where do we go here? And Trace Jackson Davis said he had banged up his leg, but he's good enough to go. So Draymond out, Steph out. And 58 seconds here with the Bulls having the ball. This is DeRozan time. DeRozan gets Moody on the switch again. Gets into the lane and rims it home. I mean, you know it. I know it. The people in the building know it.
That's easier said than done.
Pajemski is back in. Clay for three. He got it!
Well, that takes the lead.
So Clay's got 25. On an evening where the Warriors aren't making threes, he's got five made triples.
Just a pretty good screen. Got a little separation.
DeRozan again. He draws the foul. He flips it in. Bulls take the lead. In the third quarter, and at times during the game, the Warriors were double-teaming DeRozan. But down the stretch, he is eating them alive in single coverage.
Well, Kuminga went under, stays on him, but
the veteran savvy.
He's got all the tricks. I said it was going to be DeMar DeRozan, and defending without fouling was going to be tough. He just proved it there. And then the concentration to make the shot takes the lead right back. Said all the lead changes, we're still having them.
Vucevic with 31, DeRozan with 30. Make it 31 for Double D. So 2-point Chicago lead again. Chris Paul picked up the dribble. He's in trouble right now. Pajemski comes to bail him out. 10 to shoot, 12 left in the game. Pajemski driving to lay it up and out. Missed the layup, and they're going to foul Vucevic right away.
Yeah. Trace Jackson Davis set such a great screen there late to get him to the basket. He makes him. Well, he makes both of them.
Makes
it
both. It's over.
They're hoping for a miss here.
The Warriors have given some games away. This will be one that Chicago took from them.
Yeah, you're thinking about Stephen Curry. It's so unfortunate because Warriors just got healthy.
And Vucevic buries them both. So the Warriors will use a timeout. Bulls have a foul to give. You need a bucket immediately, and then you have to foul right away. So Chris Paul looking. He'll get it back. Chris Paul three. He got it. So you want a foul right away. And DeRozan, they foul him in the corner with 2.1. That is down. And DeRozan, an 86% free thrower.
Just love to get like a long screen for Klay Thompson going.
You should actually miss this free throw. Then the Warriors would be 92 feet away.
It would be tougher.
Now you have a chance to throw it. It's got to be in the front court. It's got to be a three. Quiñones from midcourt. that will do it. Leonard with 22. LeBron's hit four threes in the quarter, the second time he's made four triples in a quarter. Anthony Davis was on the bench during that run. He's back out there now. He got Powell on LeBron. Shot clock at five, and now Harden switches out. This is what James wants. He gets past him. He drives. He hangs. Missed the shot. Got it back. Goes up. Flips it in with the left hand. James, 31 points. That's his 13th 30-point game of the year. Foul called here as Terrence Mann hit the deck. They get James for the foul, his second. Clippers led by 21, seemingly moments ago. It was this quarter, but great run here by the Lakers to get back in the game. Mann in the paint, missed the shot. Davis got the rebound. Five and a half to go. Lakers ball down five. James 12 of 17, 6 of 9 from three. Mann takes him on the switch, and now you get Harden on him again. Again, the matchup LeBron wants. Shot clock at eight. James gives it up, deflected by Powell out of bounds. Six to shoot. 16 to 10 here in the fourth quarter to pull the Lakers within five. They have five to shoot. Reeves steps back, fires to Hachimura with one. He's got to put it up. Lets it fly on the baseline. And it's short. Rebound Powell. James Harden, 21 points, but the bulk of that came in the second quarter. Gets aggressive here. Missed the runner. Gets it back. Out to Powell for three. Misfire. Rebound Davis. 10 rebounds for Davis to go with 18 points. Now James with Tice on him backs up to the midcourt line. LeBron rocking it. Step back. Three on the way. James with five threes here in the quarter. Lakers within two.
How many times have we seen that signature step back three, hang dribble with the left? Oh my goodness, LeBron James, what a quarter.
19 points, his highest in a quarter this season, and he just knocked the ball out of bounds off Kawhi Leonard. LeBron James has taken over the game here in the fourth quarter on both ends. Lakers looking to tie or take the lead. LeBron coming to get the ball. Davis with the screen, so they switch Tice onto James again. LeBron fires away. Missed it that time. Offensive rebound, Davis. And fouled on the putback try. A chance to tie it at the line for AD. They've erased a 21-point deficit in about 6 minutes here.
The fifth three of this quarter for LeBron James. There's that signature move. And Dave, on the other end, in this quarter, he's taking the challenge. He's matched up directly with Kawhi Leonard. Previous possession forces that turnover.
First time in 4 years that LeBron has hit five threes in a quarter. He's got 34 points now. 19 in the fourth, the most in any quarter this season. As he continues to make the push towards 40,000 points, he's now 40 away from that. They play tomorrow night against Washington and then Saturday on ABC against Denver. AD ties the game at 106 with 4 minutes to go. Who will have the answer for the Clippers? Kawhi Leonard, guarded by James, drives past him. Goes around and almost turned it over. Deflected out of play by Reeves. 11 to shoot for the Clippers. Harden to inbound. Got to call a timeout or get it in quick. And he throws it away. Turnover by the Clippers. Lakers can take the lead as they erase a 21-point deficit in 8 minutes. Thanks to LeBron James.
Year 21. Never take it for granted, Dave.
It is just amazing to sit here and watch at age 39, year 21, the NBA's all-time leading scorer. Bring it when it matters most. They switch Tice out on him again. Shot clock at 10. Now they double. James forced to give it up to Russell. Hachimura open for the lead. No good. Davis got the offensive rebound. Back out to James. Shot clock at 8. James driving on Powell. Kicks it out. Hachimura again. Finally, the Lakers have the lead, overcoming a 21-point deficit here in the fourth. 109-106. Clippers looking to answer, 3-minute mark. Powell lost it, now gathers, shot clock at 3. Powell has to hoist. Poked away, Reed. Powell gathers and fires, and it's a shot clock violation. Now the Laker defense starting to step it up here.
And this is LeBron just making the right basketball play. Help off the strong side corner. You got Hachimura over there shooting over 40% from three. That's the right play.
Davis sets the screen, forcing the switch. Tice on James with a shot clock at 10. Now man comes to double. Corner, look again for Hachimura this time. He drives, reverse layup, good. 5 Rui Hachimura points, gives the Lakers a 5-point lead. A 12-0 run. Starting a critical stretch of the bulk of their games at home, this would be a huge comeback win for the Lakers if they pull it off. They're outscoring the Clippers 34-10 in the quarter. James Harden finally gets the Clippers a basket. And it's a 3-point game with 2 to play. 23 for Harden. James with 34 on 19 shots. Shot clock at 10 again. Tice on the switch on James. Shot clock down to 5. James gives it up to Reeves. Good look for 3. Can't hit it. Davis had it, lost it. Tice hustling, gets on the floor, but he rolled out of bounds. And it's Laker ball.
Good hustle here from Tice, but just no one to pass to. And eats the ball.
New shot clock for the Lakers. 90 seconds on the game clock. Leonard switches out. So Tice on James again with a shot clock at 15. They bring the double. They work it around to Hachimura. LeBron gets it back with a timer at 8. And now Harden switches out. Shot clock at 5. James to Russell. His three is good. And the Lakers lead by 6. 19-12. Simply amazing what we are witnessing. Bringing the Lakers back. Although Leonard with a basket out of the timeout, the Clippers still in it. Down 4. Just outside a minute to play. James had 15 points through 3 quarters. Took 1 shot in the third. Every shot he's taken in the fourth has fallen. 7 of 11 for the game from 3. Timers at 5. James, step back 3. No good. Rebound man. Clippers ball down 4. Hachimura picking up Harden at the 3-point line. Here's Leonard. He'll drive. Layup good with the left hand. Clippers back within 2. 12-second difference in the game and shot clocks. 114-112 Lakers. 12 to shoot, 24 in the game clock. Leonard on James. LeBron driving, falling away, missed the shot, rebound Harden. Clippers can tie or win on this possession. T. Lou will not call a timeout. 8 seconds left, and now Lou will call it. 9.3 on the clock. That's the Clippers' final timeout. LeBron James defending Kawhi Leonard, who catches and drives. Clippers down 2. Fall away baseline. Short. Great defense, James. Gets the rebound. Ahead to Reddish with the exclamation point. What a comeback win by the Los Angeles Lakers. And it wasn't just LeBron on the offensive end. Made a great play defensively on Kawhi Leonard to knock it out of bounds when the Lakers were down 5 and then got the stop on the final possession against Kawhi.
From 3-point range. Golden State by 3. Curry drives. Nurkic shuts him off. Allen in pursuit. Pajemski finds Green. Dangerous pass, but gets it back. Shot clock at 2. Pajemski has to put it up. Falling away. It's good. Brandon.
Then Pajemski, a three-pointer, 9 straight points, and it's a 6-point lead. Durant on the pull-up. Got it, but soft touch from Durant on the rim.
25 points Durant, 4:20 remaining. Kuminga goes right at Bradley Beal, comes up short.
Bradley Beal is big and strong.
Booker gets inside, but can't get it to go with the left hand. Beautiful move. He thought he got bumped. Grayson Allen now on Curry. Green and Curry play catch. Curry fires straight on. Booker a three-pointer. Knocks it down. Devin Booker. And it's back to a one-point game. Pajemski. Draymond Green falls and is fouled. And Nurkic just stares at him.
The two of them battle all night long. Each given the too small signal after a bucket.
You see Draymond make this move quite a bit. It looks like he's thinking dribble handoff, but instead a little, I'm going to attack the rim because I've got one guy to beat.
It's only the second team foul. Meanwhile, the Warriors have only one team foul here in the fourth. Green gets it, goes inside, throws it up, and Kuminga throws it down.
Mike, the youth that they're playing changes the entire feel of this group.
Bradley Beal gets into the paint. Has to go back to Allen. Thought about it, but the defense closed. 6 on the shot clock. Allen the drive. And deflected out of bounds. Was it kicked?
Yes, it was. It'll be Phoenix ball.
Yeah, but if it's kicked, they should reset the shot clock. It's 4.6, so apparently it wasn't.
Beal inside to Booker. Booker up top to Durant. Three-pointer. Short. Curry the rebound. 3 minutes to go. And a three-point lead for the Warriors. Curry off the bounce. Gets inside. Kicks it out in the corner. Wiggins to Draymond Green. Green sees an opening layup, banks it home. Timeout, Phoenix.
It is no coincidence their play has risen since his return.
10 games, they're 6-4 in those 10 games, and the defense has really taken a big bounce. Says Booker counted and a foul. Booker once again had a chance for a three-point play to cut it to two.
I don't know how he shoots his basketball. He actually lost control of this on the way to the cup. So you send him off a high screen, you give him a long runway to beat whoever is in front of him. Screens from both Beal. He did. He lost the ball. Takes the contact and makes the shot.
And makes the free throw. 26 for Booker. Back to two with 2.5 to go. Phoenix came into this game tied for the second best road record in the West, fourth best in the NBA. And fighting here, Draymond Green, another layup. Saw the opening and took advantage. Big buckets for Green.
Booker gets inside, layup, he banks it home. Back and forth they go.
One you expect. I mean, you expect Devin Booker to be aggressive. Draymond Green is just saying, if you're not going to consider me a real threat, I'm going to show you what a threat I am. He's 7-for-9 from the floor.
Curry's got Durant on him. Pajemski comes free. Kuminga calling for it. Back up, Pajemski gets a good look. Three-pointer. No good. And Booker the rebound. Booker drives past Kuminga, stops, leans in, short jumper, got it. Devin Booker taking charge, and we're tied again.
This guy is big, he's strong, he's always on balance, and his elevation point is ridiculous.
10 of his 28 here in the fourth. Green to Curry, long three-pointer. Back of the rim, Durant the rebound. Seeks out Booker and gives him the ball. Booker shake and bake. Wiggins stays with him. Booker crossover drives, pulls up, kicks it out in the corner. Bradley Beal. Beal pull up jumper, puts it in. Phoenix back up by two with just over a minute remaining.
So many shot makers.
Curry off the bounce, gets inside, layup is up and good. A little circus shot from Steph Curry.
That is a big time tough matchup for Grayson Allen.
We're all tied with 47 seconds remaining. Booker searching for an opening. Gets past Pajemski. Stops Pose falling away. Got it! It's a Booker barrage here in the fourth quarter. And Phoenix up by two. Pajemski, Kuminga, Curry, Green, and Wiggins for Golden State. Curry gets free. Durant chasing him. Curry off the bounce. Inside pass to Kuminga. Lays it up. Blocked by Durant. Kuminga misses the second. Peel the rebound. What a rejection from Kevin Durant. And a held ball.
Boy, they take away the lob. But by taking away the lob, they got the switch to Durant.
Green has the back tap available. Beal wins the tap. Green was looking to throw it back. And Beal stole a tap. There's about a 5 second difference, shot clock and game clock, so they don't have to foul. Booker. Curry picks him up, four to shoot. Grayson Allen. Somebody's got to shoot it. Gordon throws it back up top. Beal just gets it off in time. Side of the rim. Curry the rebound. Final seconds. And a timeout called by Steve Kerr with 2.8 remaining. Pajemski has it. Here come the screens. Curry comes free. Gets the ball, puts up a three-pointer. Bang! Steph Curry nails the three-pointer with 7/10 of a second remaining. Allen has it inside. Ball poked away by Wiggins. It's over. Or did they call? They called a foul. But there's the foul to give. Oh, this will be a very interesting call. So they call the foul on Wiggins. Clearly, we couldn't hear the whistle. And they're going to review it.
Upon review, so we can
sit here and say, well, I think the foul is here. Mark
after
Davis
the ball
is
released and with 1/10 taken off the clock. Reset the game clock to 0.6. There's a foul to give. It will be Phoenix's ball, free throw line extended on that side.
In the corner, Grayson Allen has it. Lob it inside, Durant has it, and that's it. Now it's officially over. Draymond Green deflects the final pass in, and the Golden State Warriors hang on and win a thriller.
The Wolves doing a great job of defending without fouling. They've been stout here defensively.
Trying to make it a two-possession game out of the timeout. That pass stolen by Nembhard. Two-on-one. Nesmith cuts the deficit to one. Conley has been so good at taking care of the basketball. He's dropped to third in assist-to-turnover ratio in the league. Edwards on a big night. Step back over Siakam. Can't hit. Halliburton the other way. Pacers trying to take back the lead.
Minnesota has 21 second chance points in this game.
Halliburton on the attack. Got the lay-in. Indiana up one. Conley inside, kick out to Edwards. Edwards got it back. Five on the clock. Gonna have to make a play. Baseline drive. Euro and got the roll. 36 for Anthony Edwards.
He just willed that basketball into the hoop that time. Thing was swirling around the rim.
Siakam, get it up, and throwing it down.
Kyle trying to hedge and get back to his zone that time. They rescreened Halliburton. That was nicely done by Indiana.
Late game execution in a big ball game.
We're under 2 minutes. Slow-mo. Extra pass. Conley. Pull up. Cash!
Quieting the crowd down here in the arena. What a big shot by Mike.
A long two gives Minnesota a one-point advantage. 90 seconds. Halliburton fouled. Oh, let's hope that's not a difference maker. Halliburton has tied up this game at 105. The Timberwolves heading to Cleveland to face the Cavs tomorrow. And a tight one here in Indiana. 36 points for Edwards. Pull up from deep. Cash!
Got to defend without fouling.
Turner. Travel. They don't call the travel. McDaniels with the rebound.
They missed an obvious travel by Miles.
Pull up. Yes, sir. He's unstoppable.
Taking that whole experience by the throat. Tyrese Halliburton was there. I wonder how much that impacts this game and this competition right now.
Pacers need a big three. And Turner delivers. They're within two. This game not over.
One possession game right now. Minnesota can make it a two possession game.
Edwards with 13 of his 41 in the fourth quarter. Edwards. Little Hezzy, runner off one leg, got it to drop. 43 for Anthony Edwards. Neesmith fouled beyond the arc. It's a free throw game.
Yeah. Now, the one thing for sure is that even if he knocks down all three, Minnesota's going to call timeout, advance the basketball. They're going to have to make two free throws as well. It's going to be a three-point game, and there's going to be plenty of time for Indiana to get an end-of-game situation play after their timeout. So this is the chess game that is these end-of-game situations.
Neesmith calmly knocks down.
No size on the ball either. Halliburton's going to try to play center field.
They get it into Mike Conley. Conley over to Alexander Walker. Naz Reid back to Alexander Walker. Pacers aren't fouling. And there is the foul. Took 9 seconds off the clock. And they chose not to foul Naz Reid, a 75% free throw shooter. Anthony Edwards, who's had several pressure situation free throws this season, has two big ones here.
Yeah. I don't mind the fact that they tried to go for the steal and they had a lot of clock to work with. They still have 7.2, which is a lot of time.
Gobert comes in for Naz Reid momentarily.
I mean, I'm pretty sure. I mean, Chris Finch is substituting and matching up here.
Edwards can't hit the second. Pacers have a chance. Up ahead, Neesmith. Blocked! Edwards getting up, and good night! This game's